A probe into election bribery. Former New York City Mayor Michael Bloomberg has raised over $16 million to pay for court fines and fees for felons in the state of Florida so that they can vote in the upcoming election. In Florida, felons can regain their voting rights after serving their full sentences. However, their sentences are only considered fully severed after they pay all of their legal financial obligations. All this in addition to Bloomberg's plan to spend $100 million in Florida to help elect Joe Biden. Joining me right now is Florida Congressman, House Armed Services and Judiciary Committee member, House Antitrust Subcommittee member as well, and author of the book Firebrand, Dispatches from the Front Lines of the MAGA Revolution, Matt Gaetz. Congressman, great to see you this morning. Thanks so much for being here. You're calling for a probe into bribery for Michael Bloomberg to spend all that money in Florida alone. Tell us about it.
I'm the former criminal justice chairman of the Florida House of Representatives. I know this area of law well. I spoke to the Florida Attorney General last night, and a criminal probe may already be underway in Florida. Chapter 104 Florida statutes says that it is a felony for someone to either directly or indirectly offer something of value to impact whether or not someone votes. So in this case, you have the question of whether or not paying someone's restitution and court costs constitutes something of value. And of course, this is a financial show. We know when you extinguish a liability, when you improve your balance sheet, when you improve your net worth, that is, of course, something of value. Then the next step is to determine whether or not this is intended to impact whether or not someone votes. We have a confession document, the memo that the Bloomberg team used to go and get other people to contribute to this effort literally says, we are doing this to impact whether or not these people vote. And it's not for any felon. It's not for any circumstance. They're specifically targeting African Americans because they believe in Florida, African Americans will vote 90% to 95% for Joe Biden. So this isn't an exercise in democracy. This is cherry picking votes, offering something of value for them. And I believe the Florida Attorney General has jurisdiction and is currently evaluating options for a criminal investigation. One final point, we also have a RICO statute in Florida so that this web of Bloomberg-associated entities could all be brought under the same criminal prosecution.
Well, it's pretty extraordinary that one person can spend $100 million to get somebody elected. I mean, I think if that were on the Republican side, the Democrats would be going insane. If that were the Koch brothers or something else, to see that kind of money being spent to elect somebody. And you think that this probe is already underway?
Based on my conversation with the Attorney General, there are serious concerns about the way that various organizations were set up for tax purposes, for electioneering purposes. And again, the question is whether or not something of value is being offered. When it comes to Bloomberg sort of lighting his money on fire in Florida, I think the last time he had such a quixotic electoral spending endeavor, he was trying to find his way onto the debate stage where Elizabeth Warren fed him into a wood chipper. So I think that the Bloomberg political experience hasn't been a universally positive one for him, but here he may have exposed himself and his associates to criminal liability if you're literally engaged in bribery and vote buying of a specific segment. And what is just so striking is they literally wrote a memo confessing that their intent was to do this to interfere with an election. I heard Nancy Pelosi and Adam Schiff and all the Democrats, you know, wax on for years about this foreign interference and Russia disrupting our elections. But when we have domestic election interference, domestic vote buying, we seem to be a lot less interested on the political left. I'm glad in Florida we have good law enforcement officials like our attorney general willing to pursue it. I hope we have that same diligence across the country, because I think that election interference undermining the election day vote is sort of the new Russia for Democrats. It's the new way to distract from the Trump presidency and to undermine him.
You mentioned the memo. On the memo, it reads, we know to win Florida, we will need to persuade, motivate, and add new votes to the Biden column, reads that document. This means we need to explore all avenues for finding the needed votes when so many votes are already determined. This does. It says it right in the memo. And an advisor to Bloomberg told the Washington Post, Mike wants to get this done for two reasons. One, because it's the right thing to do for the democracy, that's paying the fees of felons. And two, because it immediately activates tens of thousands of voters who are predisposed to vote for Joe Biden. So there you go.
It's one thing to motivate people. It's another thing to offer money.
Smoking gun.
Totally. I mean, when you're motivating people by paying off their fines, that's where criminal behavior may be triggered.
Congressman, let me move on to the president announcing that he will name his pick for the Supreme Court open seat this Saturday. New York Senator Chuck Schumer said that, quote, nothing is off the table if President Trump and the GOP move to fill the seat previously held by the late Ruth Bader Ginsburg. Your reaction to this fight on the left? They do not want the president to be able to name another justice.
Well, we have the power, and we're going to use it, despite what crying Chuck Schumer says. But it's quite something, with Schumer having accused the president for years of undermining institutions and shattering our democracy. Now you literally have Schumer talking about court packing. And while I know that the left today has embraced FDR's economic policies on the New Deal, I never expected that they would be embracing FDR's court packing policies. They might want to check the history books and see how that worked out for FDR. But the bottom line is that McConnell views the court as central to his legacy. I think that he's got the votes lined up. And the bottom line is there's very little the Democrats can do to stop us from seating this nominee of the president. The three women you just put on the screen, all fantastic. I think each would be energizing to the America First movement in their own way. I know Barbara Lagoa the best, someone from a working class community in Florida, got the highest degree of legal education at Columbia. But the other two women, also phenomenal. And I could tell you, after speaking to the president, he wants a pick with sizzle. He wants a pick that's going to really ignite the country and deliver on his promise to reshape the court. You know, all these never-Trump Republicans who weren't for the president, like, would they have preferred Hillary to make these picks? I think that it's very vindicating for those of us to support the president to see the bold way he's reshaped the court for a generation.
Yeah, but are they going to be able to get the vote confirmed by the election?
I think you've got a lot of interest in doing that, because even Republicans in swing seats know that if they don't face their duties and confirm the president's nominee, a lot of the MAGA voters will not show up for them. And, you know, Murkowski and Collins, I think, have played this poorly, because if they see a diminution in enthusiasm for the president supporters for them, they're very unlikely to stay in the Senate.
Congressman, your new book, Firebrand, Dispatches from the Front Lines of the MAGA Revolution, was released in stores yesterday. How are you feeling about the election now, 40-plus days away, in terms of the House and Senate races?
Look, there is no poll that can measure enthusiasm. Biden doesn't have it. Trump does. Being back out on the trail, showing that populism, that love, that patriotism, it's something I write about in my book, Firebrand. It's something the president lives every day. One county to watch, Miami-Dade County. We are seeing in polling Hispanic support surging for the president. A lot of working class Hispanics in Florida, Arizona, Texas, and around the country are not here for this neo-Marxist Black Lives Matter movement, and they're coming our way in droves.
All right, Congressman, we'll be watching, of course. Thank you so much for being here. Matt Gaetz joining us there on all of that. Stay with us. We'll be right back.